Hi everybody, it's Christina, and in this video I am going to show you a finished pocket letter and a box envelope to put your pocket letter inside. And that I'll show you that tutorial at the end. The first thing I want to show you is my finished pocket letter. And that pocket letter was from a kit that Neri sent me. And here in the video I will put a link and you can go watch that video if you like. Neri sent me a kit. And in the kit was an unfinished pocket letter. She had put cards in the 9 slots, added a few little embellishments, and then this flipbook. And she sent me a bunch of embellishments. She sent me flowers and she made really pretty embellishments. She sent me stickers. She sent me journal cards, more stickers, tons of embellishments. So on that video, after I finished that video, all that stuff was in front of me and I immediately just started making the pocket letter that evening. And then the next evening I worked on it again and finished it as fast as I could. And I'll show you right now the pocket letter. Ta-da! Thank you, Neri, for sending such beautiful stuff to work with. Okay, so everything here you see was all included in the kit. I was only allowed to use 4 things from my own stash. I was allowed, what did she say, I think ribbon was in there, washi tape. I didn't use any washi tape, so I replaced the washi with a few other things. But I'll point to what I used from my stash. I used this piece here, this little ribbon, there's another little ribbon, this pretty lace on the side, a quote that I put on a heart, and this stamp here, and I colored her in, and then the stamp comes with little sayings, so I stamped the sayings and then cut them out. And I think everything else was in the kit. Really cute, this little banner she included, so I just glued it on the front here and then added all the embellishments, and then these little cocktail glasses I put on. Live, laugh, love. This sequence here that she included, I added here and here. Enjoy the journey. I made a little, I fused the sides and then she sent me tons of sequins, so I put that in there. And here's another one of the embellishments that she made. It's really pretty. And this paper here, this paper she sent it was all plain and she made 3 embellishments. So she cut out the little cameras from the paper, colored them, and then blinged the center of them. So I just glued them right back on the paper. Thought that was cute. And then this little girl here is a stamp set that I have. So I stamped her, colored her, and then cut out the words you and me, we click. And here, and that was included in a sticker pack, cheer. And then here I have this quote here that I just cut out and then glued it onto a piece of pretty patterned paper and put a flag here. It says, friends, you're the kind of friend who would overlook my broken fence to admire my flowers. And then this little paper clip goes there, which she included as well. And then I'll turn it over, and then that's the back. And a lot of, see, all of the sequins, this is all left over from the kit. The sequins, this another banner that she made, these flowers. So I added some tags and some candy. I added more of these domino word pieces. I stamped a bunch of more girls and colored them and included them. This little girl here, I cut it out. And her sign says, love you to the moon and back. Those little tiny stamps you can get at Michael's. I just love them. Oh, I did use washi. I lied. I washi taped the side here. So I haven't been checking my camera. I hope I've been in frame this whole time. So there we go. I am so excited. Thank you so much, Neri. That was so much fun. I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to make a kit and send it to somebody and see what they can make. I love that idea. So I'm so happy with that. All right, now I'm going to show you, I make I made a little envelope. I don't know where the original one is. I think it's upstairs, but I did make another one. And I put the picture of the envelope on Instagram because, and I think I said something like, the wrapping is just, should be just as important as the gift, right? And sometimes I tend to get away from that. I just quickly wrap something up in tissue paper and stick some ribbon around it. But I try to, or I'd like to spend more time wrapping it and making it extra special. So I like these little envelopes that you can make, and you can put your pocket letter inside. And here I just made a little tag. Only if your pocket letter can fold. I have, like, say, for instance, this pocket letter that I just finished. I don't know if I could fold this, or maybe I could. No, you see, if I fold it, that this is starting to get squished here. Or maybe I could fold it this way, but no, then I've got this thing. Some I just mail this way. So some, for instance, this is a coffee pocket letter that I'm getting ready to mail out. I can fold it without ruining anything, just like so. So I'm going to grab a piece of 12 by 12 paper, and I found this in my stash. Look at that, it's coffee. It's all coffee. Cool, huh? So this is gonna be perfect for this coffee pocket letter. Now this is no way, this is not professional, okay? Now I know that there's videos out there on how to make this. I'm pretty sure there are. I'm sure I've seen it years ago somewhere. Just so you know from the get-go, there's no measurements here, there's no scoring, there is no nothing. I just kind of wing it because that's kind of how I do things. I was going to show you this paper though. This is by Stampin' Up, and the other envelope I made it out of this paper. It's almost, the feel is almost plastic. It's kind of cool, it's really cool, and this is so nice for making envelopes out of. But I'm going to use this because it's coffee, and all I do... Did I say it's unprofessional? Yep. Okay. So I just put the pocket letter right in there, and then I just fold it. Now I don't fold it together like this tight because I don't want the pocket letter to be too tight inside, right? So I just kind of fold it where it's going to be loose, and I make sure that this is going to be the top. So I just look at my paper and make sure that it's not upside down. And then I just push it down a little bit so I can see where I'm going to be gluing. And then I take this out, fold it back down, and I'm just going to check which way I want to tape it. I think I'll tape it this way. It says good coffee on the outside. Okay, and then I'm going to fold down the sides. If this was thicker paper, I'd probably be using my bone folder, which I'll do anyways. All right, then I'm going to fold up the bottom. Oh no, first I'm going to put some tape here. I use my ATG. If you want, sometimes I like using stronger tape. I use the Sukwang tape. But right now I'm just going to use my ATG gun and run tape from here all the way down a few times. Uh-oh, and Christina's out. Ha! How do you like that? This should be part of a blooper video. All right, well, I'm going to have to change the tape. Okay, and she's back. All right, so I'm just going to run the tape down the sides. This is the bottom, so I'm going to turn it around, I think, yep, and then I'm just going to fold the bottom up about, okay, I'll measure, let's see, I don't know, how much do I, let's see, it is about 1¼ inches. All right, then I am going to... Let's see, am I too far away? Oh, no, I'm not. Okay, then I'm going to open it up and push this side down. And you can see where the crease is. I'm just making it even with this line here. And I'm going to do the same with the other side. And then I'm going to fold this over about, I don't know, about to here. I'm going to fold it over to about there. Then I'm going to take this side and I'm fold it over. And when I'm folding it over, I fold it to where this is, looks even. And what I mean by that is I fold it like that, this is not even, right? So I'm going to fold it to about there. Okay, and now I want to tape these together, so I'm going to put tape on this piece right here. Push this down. I'm just rubbing it to get some of that extra tape off there. Okay, then I'm going to open the bag. I'm going to put my hand in here. And push it down a little bit on either side. And I'm sure there's videos out there where you can score the sides. But I don't really feel like it. Actually, I do it once the pocket letter's in the bag. I'll show you how I do that. And then, let's pop this in here. There's the top of my pocket letter. I'm just going to fold it over a little bit. Going to grab my hole punch. Woo. And now I'm going to go find some pretty ribbon and grab a tag. And while I'm doing that, I can, my battery is low. I can see in my camera and I'll be able to charge that up. So yeah, now I'm going to go find some embellishments, and I'll show you, I do a little bit extra on the side, but I'll be right back. All right, I'm back. I found some embellishments, and where was I? Oh yeah. Okay. So remember when I folded it, I've got that fold, that crease right there. I just kind of pinch it. That's what I do. And I sort of pinch all the way up and do that. Kind of like a paper bag, right? When you get a lunch bag. And I do the same with the other side. I just kind of pinch. And no, it's not perfect, but okay, see? I'm going to fold it over, and oh no, first I need to put my pocket letter inside. So when you're all done with your pocket letter, put it in your envelope, fold it over. Now I found some ribbon. I'm going to use this ribbon here. This is gorgeous ribbon I purchased from Stampin' Up! Last year. I just love it. Alright, so I'm just going to put that through the hole here. All right, just gonna tie a bow.
Make it all pretty, fluff it up a little.
All right, so I got some brown twine. I found this tag in my stash. I must have inked it up. And then I guess, I don't know, I must have stenciled it or something like that. But doesn't that look like coffee beans? Okay, so then I'm going to use, let me see. Uh-oh. Oh, yeah. So this is one of those Tim Holtz flower dyes. I'm just going to glue that on there. And then put this sticker on the top. It says it's coffee time. Let's put that through the hole like so. And then I'm going to put that through here. And I have this room pretty trim, I think. What am I going to do? What do I want to do? Maybe I'll just, I think I'll just glue that, hot glue it, a piece. Right like that. I want her to be able to get into this package fairly easy. All right, just hot glue that like so. Then I'm going to find an embellishment to put there. So let me just grab all my little buttons and stickers and things. Okay, I think that one. Yeah, I'm just going to hot glue that right there. And there we go. I mean, you could add some trim down there if you wanted to, but that's good enough for me. Just a really nice way to send a pocket letter, don't you think? So yeah, and I'm gonna go grab the other one that I did. This is the one that I showed on Instagram. And this is, again, that's this paper that I was talking about from Stampin' Up. Yeah, it feels plasticky. It's really cool. And it's double-sided. So yeah, really nice way to decorate, or a really nice way to add that extra touch to a pocket letter. Right? All right. Woohoo. Okay, I'm done. Whew, that's a lot of work. All right. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. Bye.